You know, in my, I guess you want to call it gaming career, I have seen a massive, massive amount of tone-deaf CEOs. And this is coming from a guy who loves Blizzard games. So, there you go. There's one strike for me. But the thing is, we have seen some truly tone-deaf comments come out from so many of them. But this one from John Riccitiello, and if the name sounds familiar, that's because it is, has made one of the most tone-deaf comments recently and has now tried to apologize for it. But the thing is this, Johnny boy, you're not trying to apologize for what you said, you're apologizing for letting your mask slip. But what am I talking about? Well, former EA CEO John Riccitiello, yes, that Electronic Arts former CEO, is now the CEO of Unity Games. That's right, Unity, that development tool that so many games are now based off of. Yeah, he's the CEO of that. And there's some more controversy that we're gonna talk about with that specifically. But you see, Johnny Boy here decided to, like I said before, let his mask slip during an interview. And here's what he had to say about microtransactions. You're gonna love this. So John Riccitiello was, like I said, having an interview with PocketGames.biz talking about monetization and about the cost of making games and things that go along with it and how a game company or developer or publisher should think about monetization when they're actually developing the game. And in my opinion, that's trash because the monetization should be, I give you the money, you give me the game. There it is. There's the transaction. That's the monetization. You give me product, I give you money. But see, Johnny Boy thinks things a little differently. Let's see what he had to say, shall we? Ferrari and some of the other high-end car manufacturers still use clay and carving knives, Riccitiello said in reference to the developers who resist monetization efforts. It's a very small portion of the gaming industry that works that way, and some of these people are my favorite people in the world to fight with. They're the most beautiful, pure, and brilliant people. They're also some of the biggest fucking idiots. Every single time we talk about video games, we gotta bring in the car analogy. It's either the Burger King McDonald's analogy or the car analogy. It never changes. Even CEOs do it. No wonder it's so perpetrated inside all of the actual fandom of video games. But let's talk about this point by point, shall we? Johnny Mnemonic over here is thinking about the actual amount of money he can rake in out of your little pockets. You see, his mask slipped, like we talked about earlier from before. He's letting you know directly up front every single time he makes a product or backs a product or puts a product out for purchase. He's not thinking of it from the perspective of, you're gonna give me money for this product. No, he's thinking about, how do I make money off of you? All the time, continuously, no matter what. How many loot boxes do I gotta put in there? How many horrible business practices do I have to do? It doesn't matter because I'm gonna do it anyways. This is the truest, best, most real reaction you could possibly get from a CEO. I mean, what other way are you ever gonna figure out that, hey, they truly are probably some of the biggest scums on the face of the earth. But let's not talk about how scummy John Riccitiello actually is from that. You see, he did something else that was truly scummy a week before. According to GamesIndustry.biz, IronSource will now merge with Unity. IronSource is a platform that enables developers to monetize their apps and shift them into business. It will become a new subsidiary of Unity, and the deal is expected to close during Unity's 2022 Q4 period. With the merger, both companies intend to enhance Unity's offerings to creators. Now you're thinking, hey, there's nothing wrong with that, man. Riccitiello just talked about monetization. IronSource is gonna help monetize. What's the big deal? Well, the big deal is that IronSource is responsible for malware. That's right. IronSource literally makes malware, direct, to the point. No qualms about it. This company deliberately makes malware that infects PCs and other devices on a consistent basis. In fact, they hold your software and devices in ransom for you to pay them. Wow, what a monetization strategy. And look at this. What's even crazier is a few weeks back, Riccitiello laid off hundreds of employees before the merger. You can't get any better than that, buddy. You just can't. But you see, now that you've got some other visuals about that going on around you, let's look at John Riccitiello's apology, shall we? Because man, Talk about completely missing the mark across the board. Reacting to the immediate and entirely predictable backlash, Riccitiello dismissed the reports of his statement as clickbait and out of context, although he added that he was deeply sorry if what I said offended any game dev. This didn't help much because several responses to his tweet noted that saying sorry if people were offended isn't really the same as being sorry for what was said. Perhaps with that in mind, Riccitiello posted a more robust apology over the weekend, saying that he is listening to criticism and will quote-unquote do better. His apology says, "I have great respect for game developers. The work they do is amazing. The creativity can be incredible, whether on a AAA, console, mobile, or indie game designed to be played by millions, or a creative project, a game made just for the sheer joy of it. One thing I have seen is that most game devs work incredibly hard and want people to play their game, to enjoy it, and, when appropriate, for players to engage deeply." He means money. "For the game devs I have worked most closely with, there is often anxiety about whether players will love the game and appreciate all the work and love that went into making it. My boy, my dude, my guy, my confidant. That is the most boilerplate. Let's run this past the lawyers. Can you double check this corporate doublespeak I've ever seen in my entire life?" I mean, this not only was brought up in like, what, less than 24 to 48 hours, which is beautiful part on your team, by the way. The fact that you are still not understanding the reason why people are mad at you and by what you've said and who you're merging with is truly the more hilarious part about this entire situation. But yet, you still continue to miss the point. Riccitiello continues in his apology, saying, "What I was trying to say and clearly failed at saying is that there are better ways for game developers to get an early read on what players think of their game, to learn from their feedback, and if the developer wants to adjust the game based on this feedback. It's a choice to listen and act, or just listen. Again, both are very valid choices. If I had been smarter in choosing my words, I would have said just this. We are working to provide developers with tools so they can better understand what their players think, and it's up to them to act or not based on this feedback." That's not at all what people are angry about. You completely missed the point whatsoever across the board. The fact is, you clearly stated that those developers who do not want to monetize with those same practices that literally put EA into the ground while you were there and you had to resign, by the way, Mr. CEO, the only thing you care about is money to line your pockets and whatever shareholders you want to include in that pocket lining. You don't care about games, you don't care about developers, you don't care about your employees, you don't care who your company merges with, you don't care what you do on the back end, you only care about the money. At least be upfront and say, "Yes, I want to monetize everything," and maybe people would have more respect for you. But no, you had to turn around and do the corporate thing like every corporation does when they get their hand caught in the cookie jar. And that's what happened. You got your hand caught, and now people will know, hey, you're a trash bag. Welcome to being a trash bag version 2, Riccitiello. It's like you're just repeating everything you did at EA, putting everything into the ground. Look, ladies and gentlemen, the reason why I made this video is very simple. A lot of people that actually show up in my content during my fanboy videos especially, they love corporations for some strange reason. I don't understand why. The thing is this, it's very simple. The corporation is there and the CEO is there to drain every red cent out of your bank account that they possibly can, whether it's by buying the game, increasing the game cost, or adding microtransactions in a full-priced game or even a free game. Look, don't trust a corporation, don't trust a CEO, they're not your friend. You need to understand this and you say, hey, why does this $70 game have microtransactions? Hey, why is this free-to-play game so incredibly insane with its practices? And how come I'm just literally being abused left and right by my pocketbook? Now you know why, because of CEOs like Riccitiello, merging with companies that literally make malware, firing hundreds of employees for no particular reason, and then turning around and saying, hey, you don't like microtransactions? Well, you're a fucking idiot. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching. If you got this far, thank you so much. If you want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe to the channel. It means a lot. We broke 28K subs, and you guys are really enjoying the different kinds of content that I like to provide. So I'm just happy you guys are here and watching. If you want to see more of my stuff, you can check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It is at Oh No It's Alex. You can also join my Discord by becoming a member on YouTube, a Twitch sub, or a Patreon supporter. Oh, and if you do decide to do that, make sure that your integrations are synced correctly, or else you just won't get a link to the Discord. That's kind of like how it works. But anyways, y'all, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.